Hi guys, in this video I'm fixing my broken air compressor. So let's take a look inside and see how things work. As you can see, I'm using a rather large compressor for airbrushing scale models. It's one of those typical hardware store models which I bought about 10 years ago. It has a 6-liter tank and is loud as hell. So back in the days I had to make a sound reduction box for it. So what's the problem? Well, the first problem started about 5 years ago. The relief valve, which protects the tank from exploding in case of a high pressure buildup, started to open before the tank was at its operating pressure. So while any normal person would replace the relief valve, I was on a tight budget, and I found a way to prevent the relief valve from opening up again. This is of course a major safety issue, so never do something stupid like this yourself. I used a compressor like that for a long time, carefully listening to make sure the motor would shut off at maximum pressure, which it did, until a few weeks ago. During my last session, I noticed the motor kept on running, so I rapidly had to cut the power to prevent it from burning up or even exploding. I realized it was time to repair this thing safely, so the safety hazard was removed and the compressor was opened up for inspection. Before you work on a compressor, make sure you unplug the power cord, release the pressure from the tank, and use safety glasses during a test. Next, I removed 3 screws in the front, 1 screw in the back, 2 screws on each side, and then the plastic cover can be removed. First, let's take a closer look at how the compressor actually works. The power cable runs to the connector of the power button. When the button is pressed, the current flows to the pressure sensor. This is basically a switch for the motor. If the air pressure inside the tank drops to 6 bar, the contact will close and the motor will run. If the pressure reaches 8 bar, the contact opens and the motor will shut off. So behind the pressure sensor we'll find the electric motor. This part is the actual motor, and this is a cooling fan mounted on its shaft to prevent overheating. The motor spins a small pulley which drives a belt. This belt then drives a larger wheel at lower speed but higher torque. The wheel has a cooling fan mounted to cool down the cylinder head and also drives the piston up and down. This is the piston head. It takes in the air from the atmosphere through a small filter. The air is then compressed by the piston and pushed out through this metal pipe, right into the 6-liter tank where the air can stabilize. Next, the pressurized air leaves the tank through this black hose until it reaches the pressure block. Here the pressure is adjusted by the user with the pressure regulator. This pressure is then indicated on the pressure gauge and flows further through the output connector. And last but not least, we can see the relief valve, a safety valve which will open if the pressure inside the tank gets too high. The first thing I need to replace is the pressure sensor. I cut the plastic tie wrap and remove the connector from the motor and the power button. The wires are pushed aside, and next a large 27mm spanner is used to remove the sensor. There's not much space to move the spanner, so I have to flip it on every turn. Then the sensor can be unscrewed, and look at that. Condensation inside the tank has caused the sensor to rust. This is why you should drain the tank when you're done using it, something I clearly should do more often. So I bought a brand new sensor, and to get an airtight fit I added some thread sealing cord. But all sorts of sealants for plumbing will work fine. Next, the sensor is screwed in place and well tightened with a spanner. Then the cables can be reconnected. Next, I unscrewed the relief valve with a 40mm spanner. Let's take it apart and have a look inside. The piece on the right adds a calibrated tension on a spring inside. The spring pushes onto a small rubber pad, which seals off the valve. If the air pressure gets too high, it will overcome the tension of the spring and release the pressure to keep things safe. After the relief valve is replaced, it's time to plug it in for a test. And look at that, the compressor stops again as it should. The plastic cover is mounted again and screwed in place. Because of its loud nature, the compressor lives in a box. This will probably raise a few questions, so in the next video I'll discuss all that in detail. Next, I connect the air hose for the airbrush, set the pressure, and with that the compressor can be used again for airbrushing. So I hope this video was helpful to someone. Many thanks for watching. Don't forget to drain your tank and see you next time.